Well, the next in the series of Ovalbore Tech buys some weird crap from China. I have a couple more CMP series cards, and these I kind of bought on a whim just to test. I only bought two, because I'm not sure if they're going to be good or not. But effectively, they're 2060 Supers called something else. So, and there's a cat meowing. This is a CMP 40HX. Let me open it up, and let's take a look. So I can see that it's an Asus Dual. NVIDIA CMP. Let's get it out of the static bag. Take a closer look at it. Well, these cards are notorious for having really junk fans, but this one is actually in tremendously good shape. Usually the second one smokes out first. PCB looks very standard. However, I'm noticing this has display outs, so I'm definitely going to test those. I'd feel much better about buying a mining-specific card if it could also potentially game, or if it still had a video encoder. I still need to test the 50HX to see if it has a video encoder, but yeah, they're pretty dirty, but that doesn't necessarily matter at all. Definitely looks like a, you know, a 1660 or a 2060, so in this case, since this is, I believe, an 8GB card, and it's a Turing TU106, it's very, very similar to a 2060 Super. So we have them booted in Windows, and I just briefly wanted to show, unfortunately, these do not have hardware NVENC encoders. And here's a shot of GPUz. These actually do show up as graphics cards. You can see them right there. So a little bit different, but I'm going to shut it down and we'll get her into Hive. Okay, Flux Mini Z. You can see they started out at 45-ish souls at, well, 130 and 180. I'm not even sure what to believe there, but let's say 43 at 133. I had to key in the memlock with NV tool because Mini Z does not support it on CMP cards. Now you can see we're doing about 36 souls at just under 90 watts, which is pretty darn good. I'm now going to shove the 1410 memory clock version over and we'll see what it does there. Okay, so the 1410 lock is a little bit higher hash rate, but the efficiency looks like it's a tad bit worse, so I still think the 1210 is a little bit better. Yeah, 1210's definitely winning. Let's try like 1095. I know 2070 Supers like core clocks down that low, but I'm not sure if the non-Supers would. I don't know, it's worth a try just to see, because we're at 0.365 efficiency, which is up from 0.350, so it's definitely better. 1095, better efficiency still, but just barely. So I think 1210 is kind of the sweet spot for the core, for Flux, and therefore probably for NEXA as well. Okay, 60 watts, looks like 292 mega hash on KASPA. Let's try upping it to the 1410 clock. So they do 338 at about 70, but the efficiency goes from 4.9 to 4.7, so I guess you kind of have to weigh the outcome there. It's probably worth the extra wattage, but I don't know. I still think I would personally, right now, run them in the more efficient 1210 5000 mode. And we're doing about 37 mega hash at 83 or 84 watts, efficiency of 0.440 and 0.447 on NEXA. I don't mind NEXA very much to know if that's good or not. I think it's reasonable. So let's try a memory algorithm. Let's try ETC and then ERGO. And then that's probably all I'll test on this tonight. Maybe ALEPHIUM. So we're seeing 830-ish mega hash at 65-ish watts per GPU. 8.5 mega hash to watt. This is ALEPHIUM. The locked here is 1210, 5000. I'm using pretty much the same OC for everything except memory hard algorithms because you can't cut down the memory any further. ALEPHIUM, KASPA would definitely have the memory down even further because they don't use it at all. But things like Flux, NEXA, DYNEX do use memory a little bit. So 5000 is actually a pretty reasonable. NEXA, not Alexa. Anyway, forgot what I was saying. Great. And unfortunately, DYNEX is not great. mainly because we can't lock the memory down. We're drawing just way too much power. So 740 is about 20% better than a good 1660 Super, but those are only drawing 60 watts. So DYNEX is no good on these. Here we have KAWPOW. You can see the, I think I was running 1100 core here and then 1250 here. So efficiency was quite a bit better at the lower core. So I do think this card really seems to like about 1200 on the core. This is KAWPOW, so I have a little bit of memory offset in there. I have 1800, which maybe is a little bit too much, but it's not a terrible card at KAWPOW, but the efficiency is only 155, and it really should be 200 for good. So let's move to ERGO, then ETC, and then we'll close out on these 40 HXs. So here's ERGO, running at about 101 watts for 83 mega hash. Not terrible, but not as good as I was expecting either. And here we see ETC or ETH hash, about 42.5 mega hash for about 110 watts. That's pretty good. I mean, that's roughly like 5700 XT pre-R mode. So very much in line with a 20 series card. Still more power than I would like, but I mean, these, I paid, I think, $78 plus fees for these, so each, obviously. So still, it's a bargain for the actual performance. Obviously, they're going to do better on memory hard algorithms because that's what they were made for, but is it worth getting one of these at effectively $78, or should you spend the extra money for $135 and get a 50HX? I'm kind of on the fence there. I do think if you're looking for memory hardened stuff, these are probably the better buy, even though the ASUS dual build quality is not necessarily the best, and these are absolutely disgusting inside, just covered in dirt. I'm actually a little bit worried about the conductive nature of dirt and these shorting out, but I'm probably just going to let them ride because if it isn't broken, don't fix it. Fans are notoriously bad on these if you work them too hard. Basically, these fan hubs are really small on the ASUS Dual, so if you run them above 80% or in really hot ambient, they'll cook. Oh, I actually had a crash. Micron memory, so 1800 memory is too high for one of these cards. Looks like GPUz. This guy is not as good. It's actually this card. I don't know, I have mixed feelings on these. I wouldn't necessarily shy away from them. If I wanted a full rig of CMP, these obviously look way cooler because you have RGB, but I still think the 50HX is the better buy overall.